room?
Yeah, no, and that's
outdated.
Hold it, yeah, I know the one I've done.
By sitting in their car and tuning to 90.6 FM, and you'll be able to hear the Mass broadcast over the radio in your car. If you're outside standing, I'd ask you please to keep your distance. We're still living through COVID-19, and while things have greatly improved, I would encourage you please to keep your distance from each other. Just it's important that we continue to maintain that spirit of togetherness yet keeping apart. So please maintain that distance. Allow the family to have their distance, and particularly at the burial, I would ask that people do not come into the graveyard for the burial of Nuala at the end of the Mass this morning. Thank you. May the Father of mercies and the God of all consolation be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Nuala died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Could I ask those family members and friends who are being admitted to the church this morning for Nuala's funeral mass to just wait outside the church, please, until Nuala's coffin and her immediate family are in the church, and then you'll be invited by the funeral directors to come into the church. Thank you. In life, Nuala cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet her with these words of eternal life. Come, blessed of my Father. In baptism, Nuala received the sign of the cross. May she now share in Christ's victory over sin and death, as we sign ourselves with the cross of Jesus Christ. In anima nahar, agus on vic, agus on spirit nave. Amen. The grace and peace of God our Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Can I once again just say to anyone who is outside the church that you will be able to access the Mass on your car radio by tuning to 90.6 FM. If you are standing outside, I'd ask you please just to keep your distance from other people who are not in your family unit or bubble. It's my sad duty to gather with you here in the Sacred Heart Church this morning as we come to receive the mortal remains of Nuala Maguire. I welcome and offer my sincere sympathy to Peter and Alice, to Paula and to Barry, to your spouses, Richard and Geraldine, and to Nuala's nieces and nephews, Killian, Oren, Orla, Shea, Caden, Phoebe, and Faith. To Nuala's extended family members who are here with us this morning, aunts and uncles, cousins, and to her close friends, work colleagues. And it's a difficult morning for all of you. Each one of you have a different relationship with Nuala. As daughter, as sister, as niece, as cousin, as colleague, as friend, as a member of our local community. So we gather with Nuala's family and with the wider Maguire and McLaughlin families to offer this Mass for the repose of her soul. Her death has shocked so many people. Her sudden end has come much too soon. And we have so many things to say, and so many things have been said over recent days about Nuala. So many stories, I'm sure, have been shared. So many memories relived. So many photographs looked at, as you can see some of them here in the sanctuary this morning. I want to just refer, as we begin our celebration, to the various gifts and symbols that are here on the sanctuary. Symbols of Nuala's very busy and fun life. Family was central to everything about her. Being the youngest of three children, I know she was the apple of her father's eye, and she was, as she often said to you, Alice, as her mother, you are my first friend, my best friend, my forever friend. She has been loved by Barry and Paula, by her nieces and nephews, by her extended family. She had so many cousins, I know, from such a huge family circle. And you all have, I suppose, have had the privilege of calling Nuala your cousin and your friend. Friendship was something so important to Nuala. Everywhere I'm told that she went, she seemed to pick up another new friend. Her sense of fun, her sense of being very much a free spirit. People were drawn to her. I know that she has been much loved by those of you here in the church as friends and others who are gathered outside and beyond. Someone whom was held dear by you, and I know that you held her dear as your friend. And I know that through the many messages of support during Nuala's illness, it says so much about the importance and the value of real and lasting friends. Nuala's faith, symbolised here this morning, reflected in the way she lived her life, and perhaps her faith was seen most importantly and most poignantly over these weeks. It's very difficult to put your trust in God when you're 38 and you're terminally ill. But she did. I saw that for myself on Friday evening when I visited her. So we thank God for the gift of faith and something that has sustained Nuala, and I know and hope will sustain you as her family today and beyond. Nuala loved her job in BT, and you're here as her extended family today, as work colleagues. She spent over 18 years there, became an integral part of the team. She hadn't, I believe, a single sick day off in 10 years, which shows how contented and committed she was in her various roles. She loved to travel, someone after my own heart. I'm sure that the fact none of us have been able to get on an aeroplane for so long would have weighed heavily upon her. She loved to go to different places throughout this country, to the US and to her beloved Spain, particularly Tenerife. And of course, her love of cars, symbolised with the small little cars here on the table. I believe that she so much loved cars that she was even unable to part with her beloved Vauxhall Coupe. It's always great when you're so independent that you can jump in your own car, that you can see where the road would take you, and that certainly is the essence of Nuala. So we gather this morning in sadness to remember, to pray for the repose of her soul, and to thank God for her life, cut too short, but for the many blessings that she has been given, and I've no doubt that she in turn has passed on to all of you here and to so many others who are not inside. We begin this morning conscious of our failings in this life, because I'm certainly not going to try and canonise Nuala, because we can't canonise any of us. So we place our trust now before God as we confess our own sins and as we ask for pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Lord, your wisdom governs the length of our days. We mourn the loss of Nuala, whose life has passed so quickly, and we entrust her to your mercy. Welcome her into your heavenly dwelling and grant her the happiness of everlasting youth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever. We sit now as we listen to God's word. I invite Killian and Fionnuala, please, to come forward.
A reading from the Book of Ruth. Wherever you go, I shall go. Wherever you live, I shall live. Your people shall be my people, and your God will be my God too. Wherever you die, I shall die, and there shall I be buried beside you. We will be together forever, and our love will be the gift of life, the word of the Lord.
Thank you. Second reading, a reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Paul addressed Timothy and said, "As for me, my life has already been poured away as a libation, and the time has come for me to depart. I have fought the good fight to the end. I have run the race to the finish. I have kept the faith, and there is to come for me now is the crown of uprightness, which the Lord, the upright judge, will give to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all those who have longed for his appearing." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. On the first day of the week, two of the disciples were on their way to a village called Emmaus, 7 miles from Jerusalem, and they were talking together about all that had happened. Now as they talked this over, Jesus himself came up and walked by their side, but something prevented them from recognizing him. He said to them, "What matters are you discussing as you walk along?" They stopped short, their faces downcast. Then one of them, called Cleopas, answered him, "You must be the only person staying in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have been happening there these last few days." "What things?" he asked. "All about Jesus of Nazareth," they answered, "who proved he was a great prophet by the things he said and did in the sight of God and of the whole people. And how our chief priests and our leaders handed him over to be sentenced to death and had him crucified. Our own hope had been that he would be the one to set Israel free. And this is not all. 2 whole days have gone by since it all happened, and some women from our group have astounded us. They went to the tomb in the early morning, and when they did not find the body, they came back to tell us that they had seen a vision of angels who declared that he was alive. Some of our friends went to the tomb and found everything exactly as the women had reported, but of him they saw nothing." Then he said to them, "You foolish men, so slow to believe the full message of the prophets. Was it not ordained that the Christ should suffer and so enter into his glory? Then, starting with Moses and going through all the prophets, he explained to them the passages throughout the scriptures that were about himself. When they drew near to the village to which they were going, he made as if to go on, but they pressed him to stay with them. 'It is nearly evening,' they said, 'and the day is almost over.' So he went in to stay with them. Now, while he was with them at table, he took the bread and said the blessing. Then he broke it and handed it to them. And their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, but he had vanished from their sight. They then said to each other, 'Did not our hearts burn within us as he talked to us on the road and explained the scriptures to us?' They set out that instant and returned to Jerusalem. There they found the 11 assembled together with their companions, who said to them, "Yes, it is true. The Lord has risen and has appeared to Simon." Then they told their story of what had happened on the road and how they had recognized him at the breaking of bread. The Gospel of the Lord. As I said at the beginning of our Mass, there has been an air of disbelief in the days since Nuala's passing, since Sunday evening, and a feeling of unreality since the onset of her illness. Nuala's admittance to the Southwest Acute Hospital on February the 25th began a journey like no other in her 38 years of life. As Nuala's family and friends, you have very much been on that journey with her. This morning we gather in and outside the Sacred Heart Church to pray this Requiem Mass for the repose of her soul and to commend Nuala to God much, much too soon. It was in this place on October the 3rd that Nuala was brought by Peter and Alice and by her godparents, her Uncle Brendan, whom I'm glad to see here this morning, and her grandmother May, to be received into the church at her baptism. She was just a month old following her birth on the 1st of September 1982. As mentioned earlier, Nuala has had a tremendous devotion to you, her family, and to her close friends. This morning's Old Testament reading, chosen yesterday by Nuala's family, celebrates relationship. In this case, that of Ruth, the author of the letter, with her mother-in-law, Naomi. And in Ruth's world, loyalty and fidelity are central to relationship. We don't have to be married to have a relationship. We have relationships with so many people. But perhaps we have a few relationships that are above and beyond the general ones that we have with many people. And there can be no meaningful bond or connection between us without a relationship being built on fidelity. As the youngest of your family, Nuala, I know, was central to your lives, and the void left by her passing can never be filled, nor should it be. Her sense of faithfulness extends to her many colleagues and friends who are, I know, heartbroken by her passing. Her sense of fun, her laughter, her free spiritness endeared her to so many, and I know that your lives are all the more empty with her death. At the outset, I referred to her love of travel, that sense of being able to simply take off and go wherever. Like so many of us, as I said, this time of restrictions in so many aspects of life, I'm sure was difficult for Nuala, curtailing her own travels, especially to Tenerife, a place dear to her heart. Almost 19 years have been spent working with BT in Enniskillen. And again, Nuala's death has robbed you of a loyal and trusted colleague in that place. The number of you whom I know stood outside your place of work in respect on Monday evening as Nuala's body was brought home speaks volumes about her. Nuala had faith, and she expressed that faith particularly by her many visits to the Marian Shrine at Knock. So many prayers have been offered for her in recent weeks, and I know that she prayed earnestly herself. the rosary with Mum and Dad each evening while in hospital. I've no doubt helped her to have some courage when it would have been so much more easy, perhaps, to simply give up. She kept saying to me on Friday evening, positivity, positivity. No room for anything else, she said, except being positive. How true that can be, and I have no doubt, in spite of terminal illness, it sustained her. Be hopeful, look ahead, think positive thoughts. It's so important whenever our backs are to the wall that we can still cling on to hope. And I've no doubt that her sense of positivity has helped you, particularly as family, to cope over these weeks and certainly this morning and over these last days. In the Emmaus story, that passage from St. Luke's Gospel that I read, it focuses very much on Easter or beyond Easter and resurrection. The risen Jesus comes up and walks by the side of two downcast disciples. And what does he do? He simply walks with them. He shares their sorrow. He didn't try to take away their sadness. He didn't tell them to dry their eyes. He didn't ignore it either. Instead, he simply shared in their sadness. Our faith in God, whatever level of faith we think we have, it does not take away our sorrow. But of course, it's not meant to. Jesus never said, don't be sad. It's understandable that our faith might be shaken by Nuala's passing, our belief system questioned. Nuala Maguire has been called in the full vigour of her youth from this world. She had time, thankfully, to acknowledge, to try and deal with her diagnosis. And as you know, she planned for this morning. In the words of that reading that Fionnuala shared with us from St. Paul to his disciple Timothy, as Paul was getting to the end of his life, Nuala likewise has fought the fight to the end. She has run the race to the finish, and she has, by her positive way of living, even at this last moment, she has kept the faith. In the sadness of this time, we pray that she is at peace. And we thank God for her peaceful death in the presence of you, her nearest and dearest, on Sunday evening. Nuala is young. She's independent. She's carefree. She's her own person. Each one of us is our own person. We cannot, nor should we be, replaced in any way. I came across just yesterday a poem by John Updike, and it's a poem called Perfection Wasted. And another regrettable thing about death is the ceasing of your own brand of magic, which took a whole life to develop and market. The quips, the witticisms, the slant adjusted to a few. Those loved ones nearest the lip of the stage, their soft faces blanched in the footlight glow, their laughter close to tears. Their tears confused with our diamond earrings, their warm, pooled breath in and out with your heartbeat. Their response and your performance twinned. The jokes over the phone, the memories packed in the rapid access file, the whole act. Who will do it again? That's it. No one. Imitators and descendants aren't the same. You, as family and as friends, have laughed with Nuala and you cry for her. We pray that the experience of those disciples on the road to Emmaus may be with all of you who grieve for her, so that you too will have courage and strength in your loss. And while memories and stories, photographs and possessions are never enough, I hope that your time with Nuala in this life may sustain you as you struggle without her. I invite you please now to stand, and I ask Orla and Tracy to come forward as those who are praying our prayers of intercession. God the Almighty Father raised Christ his Son from the dead. With confidence we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
For Nuala, who has gone from this earthly place, may God now welcome her into heaven and give her a share in his glory. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray that Nuala, who gave us so much to others during her life, may now receive much in eternal life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all who mourn for Nuala and who will miss her presence, we ask the God of hope to give comfort and hope at this sad time. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for all who cared for Nuala during her illness, especially the staff in the Royal Victoria Hospital and South West Acute Hospital. May the Lord bless them for their dedication and care. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We think of the needs of each of us present here today. May we draw inspiration from the example given to us by Nuala during her life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all who have died, we pray particularly for the deceased members of Nuala's friends and family. May God give them eternal rest. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. We just quietly offer any personal prayers now to God. Lord, hear us. Listen, O God, to the prayers of your church on behalf of the faithful departed, and grant to your servant Nuala, whose funeral we celebrate today, the inheritance promised to all your saints. We ask this through Christ our Lord. I invite you, please, to be seated as I prepare the gifts of bread and wine for the Eucharist. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favourably on our offerings, Lord, so that your departed servant, Nuala, may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, and always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices join with theirs in one chorus of praise as we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Larry our Bishop, and with all God's people. Remember your servant Nuala, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her husband, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours for ever and ever. We stand together. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. peace of the Lord be with you always. In this moment, the Lord Jesus Christ, bring eternal life to us through your Spirit. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me, even though he dies, will live. Everyone who lives and believes in me will not die forever. Alleluia. Again, if you just wait until you're called row by row, please, to come and receive the Eucharist if you so wish. And just unhook your mask as you approach me at the front. I'll give Holy Communion to those of you in the front seat here, and then Leanne can organise it. Let us pray. Grant, Lord, that your servant Nuala, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord. I want to just offer a word of acknowledgement as I come to the end of Nuala's funeral mass. Just first of all to those dedicated staff in both the Royal Victoria and the South West Acute Hospitals who have cared so diligently for her over recent weeks. I acknowledge the great turnout today here. Obviously, we are living under these restrictions, which is so frustrating at times like this. But there are many people I know who have lined the route and have been outside and who have acknowledged over recent days their sympathy to you as a family, and I just acknowledge and thank the community here, but the community that's far broader than here, and there are so many people obviously that fall into that category, neighbours, friends, work colleagues, and so on. So thank you sincerely to all of you. Can I acknowledge the many prayers and masses that have been offered for Nuala? So many people I know have prayed for her, so many people have within the family prayed with her. And the staff, I know, prayed with her on Sunday evening, joined you as Nuala was slipping from this world. So I acknowledge the great, I suppose, the powerhouse that prayer can be when so many of us pray together. And while we would wish for something different, it's so important that we still hope and pray that Nuala is now at rest and is at peace. And I know that her peaceful passing on Sunday evening has given you as a family at least that little bit of comfort, that she had indeed a very peaceful end to this life. Can I acknowledge those friends who are here? And as I said to you outside, it's a difficult day for you. It's a huge loss for you. And there are so many others that you are representing, I suppose, today. So thank you for your prayerful presence here with us this morning. Can I say thanks to Maria and to Claire for the beautiful music and singing, to Leanne and Pat as our funeral directors, to Eamon and Margaret as our sarcastans, and to all who have helped prepare for this celebration of Nuala's funeral here in the Sacred Heart Church today. There is always sadness in parting. It's very difficult to let go. And I've no doubt that your cross will be heavy over the coming times. But I also have no doubt that you will be supported with the carrying of that cross by so many others. And on behalf of the parish that we are in, the parish of Boho, on behalf of myself as your priest, I again extend my sincere sympathy to Alice and to Peter, to Paula and to Richard, to Barry, to Geraldine, and to your families, and the extended McLaughlin and Maguire families, and of course to you as Nuala's colleagues and friends. Be assured of my support and my prayers and thoughts with you over the coming times ahead. Again, I ask those perhaps who are outside to please move outside the cemetery. I'd ask you just to give Nuala's family time at the cemetery, and again we are encouraged to have burials with just a small number of people present. So please, out of respect to Nuala's family and to the restrictions that we're living under, could I ask anybody who's outside just to move out, please, outside the cemetery grounds. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. I invite you, please, now to be upstanding for our final prayer of commendation. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of Nuala. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet Nuala again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto Nuala, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Receive her soul, present her to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Nuala, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Nuala in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and we are with you and with our sister forever. In peace, let us now take our sister Nuala to her place of rest.
Hold you as Amen.